everyone, this is me Alpha back with a brand new episode of Clash Royale. And as mentioned in the title, today's video is going to be the best 2v2 deck which you can use, or else I can say the best 2v2 support deck. So as you guys can see, this is the Mortar deck. I use this deck pretty much every time in the ladder, and this is a well-rounded deck. And the main thing in this deck is this Mortar. You should not always use the Mortar as an offensive card. You should also use this Mortar as a defense, because in 2v2 modes, the opponent has so much of troops that can easily distract your Mortar, and that Mortar will never lock onto the tower. So now as you guys can see, we have a giant push incoming, and we can easily defend that push right now. So as you guys can see, we are saving up elixir right now, and my Mortar is dealing with that tombstone skeletons. So now let's split up the archers, and Lee and my friend places the golem, and that golem does not want that archer to move front. So now as you guys can see, I have a Mortar to pull that golem, and now my friend places a goblin barrel a little early on goblin barrel. If he would have waited a little bit, would have pretty much destroyed that tower. So now he clones and let's lock for that tombstone, but unfortunately he uses a tornado, which was a pretty bad for our side. So we have our princess for killing that baby dragon, but he places the mega minion. Okay, so that was an unwanted clone spell on that single golemite, but never mind, mistake happens. So now as you guys can see, I have my motorcycle back, and the field is completely reset, and both of the teams are waiting for our elixir bar to get filled up. So now rocket straight away for that elixir collector, and now my friend comes with a graveyard push. So this is a very powerful push right now. So I will probably arrow, and that level 10 archer will probably get killed by that arrows. So we are dealing a good amount of damage, and we might probably take up the tower. So 107th health left on that tower. So now my friend is a princess for defending that minions, and my opponent comes with a giant at the back. So now we decide to push on the other lane. So we have a Mortar and a golem on the right hand side, and now we need to defend this giant. So now as you guys can see, we played Nightwitch for the giant, and the opponents are defending with a mega minion and a baby dragon. So my friend also cloned a Nightwitch, which is okay. And hopefully that Mortar will straight away lock onto the tower. So the Mortar is locked onto the tower, and that tower is completely down. 8 seconds left in the game, and there is no way they can take out our tower. So that was a well played good game. So as you guys can see, how good was this deck in attacking as well as defending and creating a counter push. So let's straight away jump into another battle, and let me show you how this deck works. I will give my invite link in the description so that you can add me as your friend. So I have my friend King Shulu as a teammate, and he seems to have a fireball bait deck, which is awesome. So let's split up the skeletons and let's see what does he have. I will probably rocket that Nightwitch. So now he comes with the three musketeers. So straight away log for that three musketeers. So here comes his goblin gang. So this is a value arrow right now. So I will place my knight. Okay, I forgot that he is too playing with me. So as you guys can see, he has elite barbarians, and now let's see, my opponent places 4 elixir for defending 3 elixir. So that was a negative elixir trade. So now as you guys can see, they comes with a royal giant, which is a level 13 royal giant. So elite barbarians is a good counter to them, and now we have 4 archers attacking that royal giant, which is so awesome. And they will take care of that archers too with the help of just an ice spirit. So I paste a Mortar so that we can easily get a counter push. So as you guys can see, the Mortar is locked onto the miner, and my friend is supporting that Mortar with barbarians. So he comes with a fireball. That was a value fireball, and hopefully my Mortar will get one more hit on that tower. Yes, we are getting one hit on that tower, and we have 3 spectators right now. So minions for that knight, and my friend plays a giant wherever he needs. So now I have to back up that giant. So if he places a 3 musketeers, I will straight away rocket that 3 musketeers. So now as you guys can see, that my friend fireballs. Oh, that was a value fireball, and I will arrow that too. So skeletons and archers for that elite barbarian, and now he comes with a miner. So knight for that miner, and I will place one more Mortar as a counter push. So as you all guys can see, he will place a Royal Giant surely. My friend will probably have Elite Barbarian. So here comes his Elite Barbarian, and that Royal Giant will not get any hit on my tower. So that skeletons will distract the Nightwave before damaging my motor. So now my friend backups that motor with some minions, and now I placed my Knight. So now the push is going pretty well, and I have my another motor backed into the cycle, and that Knight. And the Knight minion and the archer probably did around 500 damage to the tower. So now I will split up my archers for that Knight and that. And I think that motor will be on the tower. Okay, the motor is on the tower. The minion is on the tower. And we are going to take out that tower. Only 5 seconds left into the game. And I will place the Knight for just defending my motor. So as you all guys can see, this is a very good support deck to use in 2v2 ladder gameplay. So that was all for today guys. If you enjoyed this video and got some information, do smash that like button, subscribe to my channel for more daily entertaining and strategic clash content, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Peace.